अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? होप सो यू आर फाइन. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई हैव जस्ट गिवन यू एन इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ मिक्सड फ्रैक्शन एज अ रिवीजन, बिकॉज यू हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट द मिक्सड फ्रैक्शन इन द क्लास. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज एडिशन ऑफ द मिक्सड फ्रैक्शन. So listen all the instructions very carefully, because this one is the new topic for you people. You have already learned about the mixed fraction, but how to add the mixed fraction, that is a new concept for you. So follow the given instructions and clear your concepts, okay? So let's start how to add the mixed fractions. Here I will explain you with the help of an example. Example is add the mixed fraction. First one is 5 3 by 5 plus 2 1 by 10. Now here 5 3 by 5 is a mixed fraction and 2 1 by 10 is another mixed fraction, because 5 is a whole and 3 by 5 is a proper fraction. What is proper fraction? When numerator is less than denominator. So this whole number, like 5 3 by 5, is a mixed fraction. Secondly, 2 is a whole and 1 by 10 is a proper fraction. Why it's a proper fraction? Because 1 is less than 10. So when numerator is less than denominator, that is the proper fraction. So 5 3 by 5 is a mixed fraction and 2 1 by 10 is a mixed fraction. Our question is how to add these two mixed fraction, that is actually the addition. So let's start. Kindly listen the instructions very carefully, because this one is a new concept for you. Let's start. Here 5 3 by 5 is the first number, and the second number is 2 1 by 10. For the addition, students, firstly you have to convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction. You have already learned about this, how to convert the improper fraction into mixed fraction into improper fraction. So follow that concept over here, how to convert this mixed fraction into improper. You should know about this, because you have already learned about this in the class. So let's start. To convert this mixed fraction into improper, first step is multiply the denominator with the whole. 5 5s are 25, and after multiplication, when you will get the answer, you will add the answer in the numerator. So 25 plus 3 is equal to 28. Clear? 5 5s are 25, and 25 plus 3 is equal to 28. Same step, we will follow the same step with the second one. Denominator is 10. Multiply this denominator by 2. 10 2s are 20. 10 2s are 20. And 20 plus 1. 20 plus 1 is equal to 21. Clear? You have already learned this concept in the class, how to convert the mixed fraction into improper. You will multiply the denominator by the numerator, and then you will multiply the denominator by the whole number, and then after getting the answer, you will add that answer with the numerator. So 5 5s are 25, 25 plus 3 is equal to 28. Now your numerator is 8. 28. Same with the second one. 10 2s are 20. 20 plus 1 is equal to 21. Here your numerator is equal to 21. So now, to convert this mixed fraction into improper, we will use the new numbers as a numerator. So now our numerator is 28 and denominator will be same, 28 by 5 plus. Here your new number is 21 as the numerator, and your denominator will be same. So we have done the conversion of the mixed fraction into improper 28 by 5 and 21 by 10. What is improper? Now, improper means denominator is less than numerator. When your numerator is greater than the denominator, then that is called improper fraction. So 28 is greater than 5 here, 21 is greater than 10, so both are the improper fractions. Clear? So first step is convert the mixed fraction into improper fraction. Got it? After converting this mixed fraction into improper fraction, the first thing is check whether your fractions are like or unlike. Your fractions are like or unlike. Here, you can clearly see that our fractions are unlike because denominators are different. What are like and unlike? You have already done this concept. Like, if the denominators are same, then those fractions are the like fractions. And if denominators are different, then unlike fractions. So here, denominators are different. That's why these are unlike fractions. These are unlike fractions. So when your fractions will be unlike, you cannot add or subtract the fractions. To add or subtract the fraction, firstly you will convert these unlike fractions into like fractions. Like fractions mean denominator will be same. So firstly you will make the denominator equal same, then you can add the fractions. So to convert the unlike fractions into like fractions, you have to check the smaller denominator. You will check the smaller denominator and you have to check that whether this smaller denominator is the factor of the greater one denominator or not. 5 is smaller than 10, so we will check whether 5 is the factor of 10. 5 divides the 10 or not. Yes, 5 divides the 10, so you have to check that what will be the multiplier, by which number you will get 10 in the table of 5. How 5 is the factor of 10? 5 is the factor of 10 by 2. 5 2s are 10. 5 2s are 10. Why I am multiplying the 5 by 2? Because I have to make the denominator equal. So I will check the smaller denominator and in whether the smaller denominator is the factor of 10 or not. Yes, 5 is the factor of 10. 5 divides the 10. So by the 2 we get 5 2s are 10. Denominator will be same. So if you are multiplying the denominator by 2, that is the rule that you will also multiply the numerator by the same number. If you are multiplying the 2 by denominator, you will also multiply the numerator by 2. Clear? Now the second fraction will be as it is because we have to convert this smaller denominator equal to the greater one. So we will just change the fraction with the smaller denominator. We will not change the fraction with the greater denominator. Now solve this. 28 2s are. What is 28 2s are? 28 2s are. 8 2s are 16. 1 carry. 2 2s are 4. 4 plus 1. 5. So our answer is 28 2s are 56 and 5 2s are 10 plus 21 by 10. Clear? As I told you that you have to just convert the smaller denominator into the equal to the greater one. So you will just work for the smaller one fraction, not with the greater one denominator. Now your denominators are same. So if the denominators are same, then those fractions are called like fractions. Those fractions are called like fractions. So when your fractions are like, you can add the fractions. Now 10 and 10 denominator is same, that's why I can directly add the fractions. Now 10 and 10. 10 is common in both fractions, so we will write the common denominator for one time as a common. and we can add the numerators. When your fractions are like your denominator is same, you can directly add the numerators and denominator will be as it is, as a common denominator. Now 56 plus 21, 6 plus 1, 7, 5 plus 2, 7. Your answer is 77. Your answer is 77 and our denominator is 10. Now, at the end, when you will get the answer, you have to check whether your fraction is proper or improper. If your fraction is proper, then that will be your required answer. But if your fraction is improper, then you will convert this improper fraction into mixed fraction. So let's start how to convert the improper fraction into mixed fraction. You have already learned about this in the class. To convert the improper fraction into mixed fraction, you will divide the numerator by denominator. So 10 sevens are 70. 7 minus 0 is 7. Clear? So if your answer after addition, if your answer is in the improper fraction, then you will convert that improper fraction into mixed number. So to convert the improper fraction into mixed fraction, you will divide the numerator by denominator. So 10 sevens are 70. Now how to write the answer? To write the answer in the mixed fraction, you will follow this method. You will start from 7. This 7 will be your whole. This remainder 7 will be your numerator. And this 10 will be your denominator. So, firstly we will write the 7 as a whole, because in the mixed fraction you have a whole and a proper fraction. Proper fraction means numerator by denominator. 7 is your numerator and 10 is your denominator. Now this one is the mixed fraction. So 7, 7 by 10 is our required answer. Clear? So students, I will repeat whole of the procedure again. Listen it very carefully. If still you have any confusion, you can clear it. Actually, our topic is addition of mixed fractions. So we have two mixed fractions. So firstly, we will convert the mixed fraction into improper fraction. So to convert the mixed fraction into improper fraction, you will multiply the denominator by whole and then add the answer in the numerator. So that new number will be your numerator and denominator will be same with the second one. After converting the mixed number into improper fraction, you will check whether that fraction is like or unlike. Now here our fraction is unlike because denominators are different. And when your fraction is unlike, your denominators are different, you cannot add the fractions. To add or subtract the fractions, your fraction should be like. What is like fraction? It means your denominator should be same. Here we have different denominators, so we have to convert this unlike fraction into like fraction. So to convert this unlike fraction into like fraction, you will check the smaller one denominator and check whether this smaller denominator is the factor of the greater one or not. Here 5 is the factor of 10. So we will multiply the 5 by the number by which you can get the 10. So 5 2s are 10. If we are multiplying then any number by denominator, we will also multiply the same number by the numerator. Here we are multiplying 5 by 2 because to get 10, to make the denominator same. So 5 2s are 10. And we are also multiplying the same number by the numerator, so 28 2s are 56. Now our denominator is same, like fraction. If your fraction is in like, then you can add the numerator. So we can directly add the numerator and denominator will be here as a common denominator. Now after addition, we are getting 77 by 10. That is improper fraction. So after addition, if you are getting the improper fraction, so the rule is convert this improper fraction into mixed fraction. To convert the improper fraction into mixed fraction, you will divide the numerator by denominator. You have already learnt about these all concepts. So you will divide the numerator by denominator, and this one is the method how to write the number into mixed fraction. 7 is your whole. This 7 will be your numerator and 10 will be the denominator. So hope so students, you have learned this concept very clearly. Still, if you have any confusion, you can watch the video by yourself again and again. Inshallah, in the next lecture I will again start the same topic, addition of mixed fraction, with some different examples so that you can clear the concepts in your mind. One assignment will be attached along with this lecture, so solve that assignment by yourself. Watch the video again and again, and kindly solve the assignment by yourself. Okay, thank you.